Kia ora, and welcome to the latest flyover of the Te Ahu, Turanga, Manawatū Tararua Highway. I'm Tony Adams, Project Director for the Alliance, and I'll be talking you through our recent progress as shown on this flight, completed on Saturday, 18th September. As you can see, the flyover starts at the Ashurst end, as we just fly over the intersection of State Highway 3 and 57. And the future roundabout will be out to the right-hand side there, as can be shown in the animation on the top right-hand corner. There's our site office, specifically built for the project, and it houses just under 100 personnel from supervisors up. As we head towards the east, you can see Nutcracker Farm underpass is partially completed, and then also the new building to the right is our on-site lab facility. Temporary car park for gorge walkers up to the right. That's busy today, being a Saturday. And then we come across where Parahake Island Bridge is. So you can see the temporary staging is now complete and the piling operation is well underway. That bridge is 312 metres long and it's of a balanced cantilever construction. And it's very complex and one of the widest bridges in the Southern Hemisphere. Up over the railway line, and then there's a land span of a short distance here, and then we go into the Eco Viaduct, which is another 310 metre long bridge, but more of a traditional construction made of steel plate. Challenging ground conditions, and we're just working through issues around high artesian water pressures. We hope to start piling early in the new year. As we move off the end of the future Eco Viaduct bridge, we go into an area called Fill 9, Zone 2. This is one of the bigger fills on the project, and when completed, it'll be 1.4 million cubic metres. The project itself is broken into four areas. So we've got Zone 1, which is south of the Manawatū River. This is Zone 2, which goes up onto the top of the QE2 covenanted land. Zone 3, and then Zone 4, right down towards Woodville. So the cut fill line of Fill 9, Cut 12 is just in front of us here by that pond. So most of that material that's in front of the camera there gets removed and taken down to fill into Fill 9. As we continue to head east, we're up into the top of what we call QE2. So to the right is QE2 covenanted bush. So we're right at the top of the headwaters of that and we minimise our footprint. This area here now is called Cut 13. So that's the biggest cut on the entire job. It's 2 million cubic metres and 57 metres deep. And this is where we start threading our way through the Te Apiti wind farm. You can see a couple of excavators there. So one's parked up and one's working. So they're both 75 tonne excavators. Big slot to your right is what we call Meridian Access Track 1. So that's key to get that road or access into there for a future Meridian access, as well as relocating a cable. And that'll allow us to dig more material out from directly under the camera where that moxie was. Total earthworks on the project is 6.6 million cubes. And season to date, we've done 650,000 cubes. So we're about 10% of our way. Next season's a big season, and we hope to get approximately half the earthworks completed. This season's been about a lot of enabling and getting access into the cuts as well as the fills, so that we can make big progress this earthwork season, which starts traditionally on the 1st of October, and then goes through to late April, early May, just depending on what the weather does. Also, as part of the project with mitigation that has to be completed, we've got stream mitigation, which is off-site. We've had a successful planting season, and the boys and girls have just put 200,000 plants in the ground of their 250,000 target. In total, there's 1.8 million plants going to be established through the duration of the project. Here we're getting into zone 3 now, Cook Road. That's another satellite compound that's been set up. A couple of days before the flyover, it's been pretty wet, so you can see the water conditions are pretty damp around the place, and there's not a lot of activity happening on site on this Saturday morning. And just up right up through here is pretty poor ground conditions, which will require significant undercuts so that we can get a good base for the road to go on. Out to our right is one of our several disposal sites. That particular one's disposal site 28. We've got about 1.2 million cubic metres of excess material, so they were put in those disposal sites, just going over the top of a erosion sediment control pond, and that'll control the future runoff to allow cleaner water to be discharged into the environment. Progressing now through into Morgan Road, and you'll see the Morgan Road underpass, also known as Bridge 10. That's one of three underpasses. Bridge 10, Morgan Road, as I said, Nutcracker Farms, and then also there's one back at Cook Road, which allows the shared use path to go from the southern side to the northern, as well as future meridian access to the Te Apiti wind farm. Big cut through here. Morgan Road underpass is progressing well, with the base and both walls now poured, and now the work teams are just working on pouring the roof. Down through Ag Research, this is very steep terrain and quite challenging. It swings around to the right. That pond will get removed and relocated. Got approximately 220 staff on site at the moment, and that'll get to a peak of 350 next season. And that's when we start the pavement construction, but still be completing earthworks in other areas. So all these pines will be removed in October. And then we get into another big cut 28. So you'll see in the animation on the left, there's a big sideling cut, which is quite challenging. All the vegetation has been flattened and removed, and that was a consent conditions around roosting birds. So with that down now, that will stop birds getting in amongst there and nesting in the period that we want to dig it up. Challenging gully right here in front of us is gully 20. And all winter we've had crews down in the base of that gully mucking it out, putting undercut gully drains in there, and then slowly placing material to lift the footprint, and then that'll come right up to the ridgeline in time. Another disposal site out to the right-hand side. And you can see that grey material, that's a papa material, kind of a sandstone. We've got three main kind of materials. We've got conglomerate, which is more down the western end, and then we've got alluviums at both extremities of both ends down on the flats, which is quite a poor material. This papa material is actually quite dry, so it's been good to do construction fill with during the winter period. Pushing on through here, this is the site of the last bridge, the Munga Manaya, and that's a relatively simple Super T construction, but it has got a fault line near there, so there has to be some tricky stuff built in amongst the abutments, so that allows the bridge to slide in the case of an event. Over the flats here, there will be a heightened causeway constructed, and then leading into a roundabout that'll tie into the Woodville Highway. You can just see that coming up on the animation on the left-hand side. So thanks for watching. and I look forward to sharing future progress